Come in.
Mrs. Barton, Mr. Lakin for you.
Thank you for coming, Mr. Lakin. Francis Barton, Peter's wife.
My deepest condolences, Mrs. Barton. We've lost two very special people.
Please sit.
You asked to see me?
I wanted to ask what you know about the relationship between my husband and your daughter.
She thought he was a tremendous employer.
Were you aware that they were having an affair? Oh, you were. Do you know how long for?
Is this why you've asked me here? To ask questions you already know the answers to?
Oh, I have so many questions, Mr. Lakin. And so few answers.
I think I should leave.
My husband left 20% of this factory to an unknown party. Did you know that?
Now, look, I don't know what game you're trying to play with me.
Oh, I'm not interested in games, Mr. Lakin. I'm only interested in finding out the truth.
I thought as much. You've brought me here to tell me you're going to contest the will.
Oh, even if I wanted to contest the will, my solicitor tells me that I have no grounds.
A 20% share can't affect any decision made by the 80% shareholder.
But they will always be there, won't they? In the background. A constant reminder.
Oh, listen. It fair knocked us for six when we learnt what he left
her. Oh, I can imagine.
Whatever we decide to do with it, it will be in Noah's best long-term interests.
Noah?
That the legacy now passes to him will be small consolation for the loss of his mother, but the annual dividend will cover his schooling and the capital should secure his future.
Her son? Helen has a child.
You didn't know?
I had no idea.
The presence of a bastard in one's family isn't something to shout from the rooftops. Even one as splendid and sharp as Noah.
How old is the boy?
He'll be 11 come November.
11?
Helen brought him up here all the time. Noah loves his visits to the factory. Uncle Peter explaining how everything works, spoiling him rotten with sweets and toys. Your husband really took the boy under his wing.
Since when?
Since the day he was born, Mrs. Barton.
What do you think?
I think it's a great deal of money.
I'm sure you'll agree that a sum of this size would provide your grandson with backing to do whatever he wanted in life.
Yes, it would. It would certainly reassure my wife to know that Noah had financial security when neither was in the best of health.
Mr. Lakin, you were expressly asked to keep the child out of this meeting.
Noah, I told you to play out on rec until I came to fetch you.
He's a fool. Not with a tennis ball, a real cricket ball. I swung the bat and followed through and ran all the way to the boundary. Who are they?
I have to say the offer is very generous, Mrs. Barton, but in considering it, I have to take into account the wishes of two people.
Two people?
Noah and Peter.
I'm sorry, Peter.
Your husband didn't leave Noah a sum of money to spend or invest, Mrs. Barton.
My husband didn't leave anything to Noah, but to your daughter, his mistress.
Peter bequeathed Helen a portion of his business for the benefit of herself and Noah, a portion we can reasonably assume was intended to pass to Noah upon Helen's death.
I think that's a reasonable assumption, don't you, Francis?
I suppose so.
That is how I interpret Peter's intention. I have to respect that intention. For that reason, your offer for Noah's 20% is declined.
Forget what Peter may or may not have had in mind when he drew up the will.
I can't, Mrs. Barton. Oh, I understand how you must feel about him.
You couldn't even come close.
Peter is the boy's father. I have a duty to uphold what I believe to be his last will and testament towards his son. Noah will remain as a shareholder. It's great, isn't it? Hey, you could play cricket
I will
here.
Not be forced into a relationship with the boy.
Stop calling him the boy.
I'm regarding Noah as a temporary evacuee, nothing more.
Oh, good morning, Mrs. Barton. Mrs. Collingbourne.
Good morning, Mr. Lakin.
Hello, Noah.
Would you take... show Noah inside? Take him to his room.
Of course. Come on, Noah. We'll go in two by two.
I won't leave without saying goodbye.
Shall I take his case?
Oh, yes, thank you. I know this isn't easy for you, Mrs. Barton, but my wife and I so greatly appreciate you taking Noah in while we look for a place to live.
How long before you find something?
Well, they've been told within 2 weeks, but it might prove longer. It's a weight off our mind knowing that Noah's in a place of safety.
Oh, it would be a mistake to describe Great Paxford as a place of safety. A month ago, an unexploded bomb had to be defused just 50 feet from where we're standing.
3 nights back, 160 planes started bombing the living daylights out of Liverpool, handing out similar every night since. Thousands of people have lost their homes.
Point taken. We'll do our very best to look after him.